Canceled because of low interest. New at 10, Joe Hinkey with the reason Sand Springs will not hold its annual Soapbox Derby and when it could return. Joe?
Well, Russ, I'm told some years anywhere from 60 to more than 100 people built Soapbox Derby cars and raced on the streets of Sand Springs. But I found out this year the 7th annual Sand Springs Soapbox Derby will not take place. First to the bottom of the hill is what the Sand Springs Soapbox Derby is all about. But this year, city staff decided it would be best to bring the race
Absolutely.
To a halt.
You know, we don't make a decision like this very lightly. We want to make sure that any funds that we spend on community events, that they're done appropriately.
In May, the city put out registration forms for the Derby and then nothing until about a week ago when Sand Springs canceled the race. Between May and August, the city lost its marketing manager and recently just hired a new one.
So I came into this fun project and, you know, just had a couple of weeks before the deadline.
A few weeks until September 13th, the day of the Derby, and only about 5 children had signed up to get behind the wheel of their own Soapbox Derby car. So unlike years past, the hill running through Broadway and Main will not become a one-day Derby course.
Certainly we had people that were very competitive and really wanted to win on the competitive side.
Troy Cox, one of the sons at Cecil & Sons, sponsors of the Derby. Cox enjoyed seeing families coming together for it, but with a lack of marketing this year, he understands.
I could wish for more publicity of happening, but at the end of the day, I understand why with 4 weeks to go and just 4 or 5 entries, they felt perhaps it was time to pull the plug and rethink how it was marketed.
Now, Casey St. John with the City of Sand Springs tells me the Derby could return next year. City staff and volunteers plan to meet, discuss the race, and find ways to improve it, either as a standalone event or part of another City of Sand Springs event. Joe Hinkey, 2 News, works for you.
All right, hopefully it'll come back.